Does that not make it harder to govern? I mean, when you're in the opposition, I understand, and this is not just you in Malaysia, it's anywhere. When you're in the opposition, you want a more independent judiciary. You want to be able to go to the media and make your complaints. You want the court system to work more quickly. But when you're in power and you allow all this stuff to happen, does that not make it more unwieldy to govern?
Yes, you are right. Absolutely right. That is the people do make adjustments when they're in power. I cite, for example, the experience in Indonesia. It's quite amazing. Because after that transformation, the free media, the first to be attacked and besieged, other than the Suharto or the past, is the new leaders. Mm-hmm. But they have been able to withstand that and have accepted that as, norm, because they have given clear guarantee that that will be protected. So it has happened. And to me, what happened in Indonesia is very, very important as a showcase, because it could work in Indonesia, although the threshold in terms of economic development is far lower than us mm-hmm. in Malaysia. So
that was a successful transition.
Yes, very successful transition until now. And I was citing these massive demonstrations these days against the president over this bank century mm-hmm. scandal, but the president stood firm. Yes, you have every right as long as you don't break the law. I mean, don't destroy buildings or structures, but otherwise you have every right to express your disapproval.
And you want to see that in your country?
It has to happen. It has to happen. And we have to come very clear. We have to to propose specific recommendations and even time frame, because otherwise the public will perceive us as, just like the old mm-hmm. politics, style politics, giving all sorts of excuses to delay and defer reform.
All right. We were talking about you as opposition. Speaking of opposition, I know that this is a private visit and you're a private citizen, but I note that when you come here, you visit friends, and invariably they tend to be with the opposition. Mr. Estrada, Mr. Aquino are on your agenda. What do you talk about with them?
No, I meet friends. And they can be from the government or from the opposition. Just happened that my, the two family friends, very close family friends, I've got a number of them, but then which we have gone for a long time is the Aquino family and President Arab. So I almost invariably in every visit that I made from the time I was in government till now, I've not failed to meet and discuss with them. Well, we discuss them about policies, family, and then move on to what's happening. And now that they are going to be presidential candidates, they are presidential candidates, and what do you stand for? What about this reform agenda? What is the level of support? And
so you compare notes.
We do compare notes quite a bit. Yeah. Mm. Yeah,
but I also know that the President Estrada is, he's not just an ally politically. He stood out. He stood up for you at the time when you needed it. But it's also a personal friendship, isn't
yes.
it?
Yes, it's true. I mean, with the President Estrada, for example, he broke even the normal ASEAN sort of norm of non-interference to the extent that you can even ignore friends in difficulty. I didn't share that sentiment. That's why he met my wife Aziza in Kuala Lumpur and invited my daughter to Malacanang. And then the late President Cory Aquino, in fact, received Aziza, arranged for her, like her own sister. And it went a long way since then. And so I think, that speaks volumes about the, not only personal friendship, but then the passion of many of my friends and colleagues in Filipino, the media for the matter, on the issue of freedom and justice.
People here who know you and people who have followed you are wondering now what's going to happen to you when you get back to Malaysia, because I know you're facing a trial again. So what do you think is going to happen?
Que será, será. Well, these are trumped-up charges, and as I've said, it's the first time in the history, recent history, that you can prefer a charge with no prima facie evidence, just using one person, enrich him, and then say whatever to smear. But we have then taken a proper, my counsel, line of defense by adducing whatever evidence that we have, medical evidence, to prove that these are all, you know, frivolous charges. Mm-hmm. And from the word go, I mean, it's quite known in Malaysia. This is the first case where it took 6 months to get the police report. I mean, anywhere, in any case, you get it the same day. Mm-hmm. And then is the first case. We can't even get documents. Today, the federal court rejected my application to get documents to prepare for my defense. So you can understand the charge, because they are bent in on proceeding, but I believe that we can not only withstand our support level, but then to push the agenda forward and expose them.
But is there a chance that you could be thrown back in jail when you get back?
Well, that's of course the Najib plan. I mean, Prime Minister Najib, his wife and his cronies were all deeply involved in this. The instruction that goes to the police and the Attorney General is quite known. I think that's the only way to deflect from some of the serious issues against him. I don't think that is the right thing to do. I mean, you face on, let us, you know, be civil about it, fight about it. After all, I'm the elected leader of the opposition.
Mm. And how does that affect the momentum now that's being renewed in the opposition if they try to throw you back in jail?
No, the activities to them are further enhanced. It's not only me, you know, Ricky. Almost every single opposition leader is under investigation or being charged for sedition, for unlawful assembly, for corruption. I'm not serious corruption. I mean, going through the files, they led to one death. Remember this young political activist over 2,000 ringgit investigations that led to his death. So we have actually serious problems here. So because of that, the opposition have taken a position that no, we have to be very firm and tough in our battle against the government. And we have seen the last couple of weeks and months this growing, you know, anger expressed in many of the rallies.
Well, we eagerly await to see what happens to you when you get back, and certainly people here in Manila will be also monitoring developments. Anwar Ibrahim, as always, pleasure to have you again. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Ricky. See you in Kuala Lumpur. See you in court.